Okay. Doesn't play. Okay. One day we will have new harmonium in new mridang. Kapijana valava girivara dhari Kapijana valava girivara dhari Yashoda nandana bracha janarandana Yashoda nandana bracha janarandana Yamunate ravana Vanachari Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Vihari Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Vihari Tapidana Valava Girivara Dhari Tapidana Valava Varadari Yashoda Nandana Bracha Janarandana Yashoda Nandana Bracha Janarandana Yamuna Tera Vanachari Yamuna Tera Vanachari Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Vihari Madhava Kunda Bihari Kapedana Valava Girivara Dhari Kapedana Valava Girivara Dhari Yashoda Nandana Bracha Janarandana Yashoda Nandana Bracha Janarandana Yamuna Tera Vanachari Yamuna Tera Vanachari Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Jaya Prabhupada, 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 Jaya Prabhupada, Jaya Radha, Damodara Radha, Damodara Radha, Damodara Sri Radhe, Jaya Gauranitai, 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 Jaya Gauranitai. Dhamishapad Paramahamsa Parivradikacharya Shtarishata Shishimad His Divine Grace Hissi Bhaktivedanta Samaraj Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. Dhamishapad Paramahamsa Parivradikacharya Shtarishata Shishimad Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Maharaj Prabhupada Ki Jai. Ananta Koti Vaishnavrinda Ki Jai. Nama Acharya Srila Haridas Thakur Ki Jai. Premsakaho Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Ki Jai Gangamaya Munamaya Ki Jai Tulasi Devi Bhakti Devi Ki Jai Samavet Bhakta Vrinda Ki Jai Nitai Go Premanande Haribo. All glories to the assembled devotees, Hare Krishna. All glories to the assembled devotees, Hare Krishna. All glories to the assembled devotees, Hare Krishna. All glories to Shri Shri Guru Gauranga. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. You're still around till 8, right? Huh? You're still around till 8 o'clock.
I was going to go see my family.
Oh.
I'll go okay. Do some cut up now. But.
Okay. Well, just text her when what time is she coming for the cups. Say that you cannot access the cups.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
Thanks. Okay, so we're reading 4th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, chapter 26. King Puranjana goes to the forest to hunt, and just a second. I think it should be verse 14. Yes. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. So Hare Krishna, dear devotees, good morning. Thank you for joining Srimad Bhagavatam class. And I'll just read Sanskrit. Antapura Striyo Prichat Vimana Iva Vedishat Apivakushalam Rama Sheshvarinam Yathapura. Antapura Striyo Prichat Vimana Iva Vedishat Apivakushalam Rama Sheshvarinam Yathapura. Word to word translation. Antapura, household. Striya, woman. Aprichat, he asked. Vimana, being very much anxious. Vimanaha, being very much anxious. Iva, like. Vedishat, O King Prachinabarhi. Api, weather. Vaha, your. Kushalam, good fortune. Rama, O you beautiful woman. Sa Ishvarinam, with your mistress. Yatha, as. Pura, before. Translation. At that time, King Puranjana was a little anxious, and he inquired from the household woman, "My dear beautiful woman, are you and your mistress all very happy like before, or not?" Purport. In this verse, the word Vedishat indicates King Prachanibarhi. When a man becomes refreshed by association with devotees and awakes to Krishna consciousness, he consults the activities of his mind, namely thinking, feeling, and willing, and decides whether he should return to his material activities or stay steady in spiritual consciousness. The word kushalam refers to that which is auspicious. One can make his home perfectly auspicious when he engages in devotional service to Lord Vishnu. When one is engaged in activities other than Vishnu Bhakti, or in other words, when one is engaged in material activities, he is always filled with anxieties. A sane man should consult his mind, its thinking, feeling, and willing processes, and decide how these processes should be utilized. If one always thinks of Krishna, feels how to serve him, and wills to execute the order of Krishna, it should be known that he has taken good instruction from his intelligence, which is called the mother. Although the king was refreshed, he nonetheless inquired about his wife. Thus he was consulting, thinking, and willing how he could return to his steady good consciousness. The mind may suggest that by vishaya bhoga, or sense enjoyment, one can become happy. But when one becomes advanced in Krishna consciousness, he does not derive happiness from material activities. This is explained in Bhagavad Gita 2:59. Vishaya vinivartante niraharasya dehina rasavarjam rasapyasya param drishtva nivartate. The embodied soul may be restricted from sense enjoyment, though the taste for sense objects remains. But seizing such engagements by experiencing a higher taste, he is fixed in consciousness. One cannot be unattached to the sense objects unless he finds better engagement in devotional service. Param drishtva nivartante. One can cease from material activities only when one actually engages in devotional service. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Ganandana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chitanya Manobishtam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Svayarupa Kadamahyam Tadati Svapadantikam. He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopisha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostate Tapta Kanchana Gaurange Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sutta Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vanchakalpa Tarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhya Evacha Patitanam Bhavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda. Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Shrimate Bhakti Vedanta Swamin Iti Namine. Namaste Sarasvati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatyade Shatarine. So I'll read the verse again. Antapurastriyo prichat vimana eva vedishat apiva kushalam rama sheshvarinam yatapura. Just put this a little higher. At that time, King Puranjana was a little anxious. He inquired from the household woman, "My dear beautiful woman, are you and your mistress are all happy like before or not?" So I was asked to give this class today instead of Yashodev Prabhu, so this is a spontaneous class for me. So I would like you to be more active in participation so we can discuss. But I'll just say a few words about this purport by Srila Prabhupada. It's actually quite straightforward, and it explains about the essence of our practice. Not just the essence, but also the benefit or the strengths of our practice. Because unless you have practical engagements for your senses in devotional service, there is no way that the senses could be just subdued, suppressed, they can be temporarily, but then eventually they will burst with even stronger force, especially the mind being the center of all the chief of the senses. And that is why when Srila Prabhupada introduced Krishna consciousness, he gave us such a variety of services, how to engage all our senses. Just imagine, if he would just focus on certainly the main activity in this Kali Yuga in terms of bhakti, and that is Harnama Eva Kevalam, Nil Madhurya. Where's me? Sorry. So if you take just the process of chanting, hearing and chanting, and you engage your ears and tongue, but you wouldn't have deities, which is basically the previous age, Dvapara Yuga, main dharma, Archanam. But if Prabhupada would not be introducing this, temples, building temples and archana, what pleasure would our eyes derive from? Where would they be looking at? What our nose would be smelling in terms of, beautiful incense or flowers? It would be very difficult. In other words, Kali Yuga contamination is all over the place. And if such beautiful oases would not be created and give us, of course, a lot of engagements right away, because anything that you do in a temple or a farm where the temple is, this is all done for pleasure of the deities. And not only it helps us to focus, but also it purifies our consciousness by those senses being engaged properly. Sense of touch, of course, pujaris bathe deities and do so many things, but even if you don't have second initiation, or even no initiation at all, you still can clean the temple. You can work in a garden. You can help with milking cows or taking care of cows, and so forth. Or serving those who are, engaged in the service, you can help them, you can make garlands, etc. So I remember when I lived in Czech Republic, even when I took initiation already, we lived quite away from the temple. It was about 3 hours drive, and I had to take three different buses to get there, and it took me 3 hours to get to the temple. And I was going, at some point I was going every week, every Sunday, just to clean the temple room floor after the morning program before the Sunday feast. And if I had time, I would also clean toilets in Brahmacharya Ashram. And I was doing it for at least a year, like every Sunday. And then we had to move to another country, and I was amazed how those samskaras were very deep. I felt, I even had a dream that I came to the temple of Gornitai and was cleaning this floor, which I was cleaning every Sunday. And this was a very strong samskara, which helped me to, you know, I felt very much intimately connected with deities. Can you believe it? I mean, you don't need to be a pujari to be intimately connected with the deities. The only thing you need is to have some regular service to the deities, which pleases the devotees. In other words, which is most needed to the deities. Right now, I have friends from Prague who we used to care for. We still are distantly, but not it's not the same. And they got the attachment, because we used to travel to Navraj Dham, to Hungary, at least four times a year to see beautiful Radhesham deities, offer some service there, and of course rejuvenate through hearing and chanting. It was like a visit in a dham while being in Europe, which was very nice. And I have to have a phone to quote you the verse from Bhagavatam, but anyway, maybe I can do it through the internet actually. But what I want to say is that they will be going next week to the dham, and they asked me to help them to reserve Mahaprasadam place and things like that. And I also said to them, I know that you need to bring gifts. Whenever you come to see the deities, you're not coming empty-handed. But I said, there's a way how to bring gifts on like a next level, level up. And that is, you have to ask head pujari, what is most needed to please the deities right now? What is the most needed items for worship? In this way, not only you bring gifts, but you also bring gifts which are needed, which is, it's very easy to please, you know, pujaris or whoever takes care of deities by bringing what they need. It's so easy. The only thing you need to do is ask. And then, of course, Krishna willing, you can find those items, because sometimes, you know, they can be some specifics. So they did this, and of course, I taught them that before you go to Radhesham, and that's how we did always. We first went to Budapest to see beautiful Shishidayal Nitai Vijay Goranga deities. So in this way, you get the mercy of Gaur Nitai before you enter the dham and see Radhesham the same day, because it took 6 hours from Prague to drive to Budapest and get the darshan. We left in the morning, get there by lunch, had lunch, kirtan, and then went to Radhesham and just in time for the evening arati. So that's like the journey to the dham. And so they're going to do the same in 1 week. And I said, and you also have to ask pujari in Gornitai temple what they need to get the items there. So they were happy, and we asked the head pujari, so they gave the list of different dry fruits and rose water and saffron and other things. And so now they have 1 week to find those items. And so, in other words, the preparation to visit the dham starts well in advance. And I told them, even this time, I told them, look, you're going only for 4 days, which is like 3 nights. It's a short time visit, but it's enough to go very deep. But you need to prepare your consciousness. You need to, in advance, start meditating. Like when Uddhava was, Akrura. When Akrura was visiting Vrindavan, his meditation of how he will pay obeisances to the Lord, how he will see his footprints, all started in advance. In fact, he kind of projected what will be the scene when he will enter Vrindavan. So he had gotten such an ecstasy that all of the road to Vrindavan, supposed to be from Mathura, like, I don't know, just over an hour or so, he went like the whole morning, the whole afternoon. He was, because he was in this, absorbed in this meditation, he couldn't go fast. The horses, he just, you know, although it was brand new chariot, as we remember, with, you know, fresh horses. No, he went very slow. And exactly when he entered, he started seeing auspicious signs of deer passing on that side, and then hoof prints, and then the footprints of the Lord, and the ecstasy arose, and tears came up, and ecstasy symptoms developed in his body. He started to roll in the dust, paying obeisances to those footprints, and ecstasy escalated more and more as he was entering Vrindavan. So by the time he saw Krishna and Balaram, you know, he was like fully prepared to eat them up with his eyes, you know. That's how he was anxious. So I said, you have to do the same. I mean, we cannot do the same, but we should follow in the footprints. That means, in the footsteps. That means that we have to meditate on seeing Radhesham, what I want to bring them as gifts, how they will like those gifts, you know, and this. And then while you're in Prague, or whatever city you are, you know, it's a capital city, there's a lot of, you know, Kali Yuga city, everything is there. But you're going through those shops with one's constantly meditation. I want to bring those items for Radhesham. So you're in the spiritual world right there, while being shopping, which usually you shop for your sense enjoyment, right? You come to the shop, I mean, not devotees, but usually people do that. But even devotees may have that tendency, you know, the old habit. You come to the shop, oh, this looks good, you know, how it will please me, my tongue. But here you have the item list, the list of items for the Lord, and you're already seeking, is this on this shelf? Is this on this shelf? Oh, how it will please the Lord, you know? It just changes your consciousness. So the verse I wanted to quote, and I don't know, I maybe have to open the database quickly. Lila Madhuri, can you bring me the phone, my phone? There's a verse in the 7th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, 14th chapter, I think. It says about visiting the pilgrimage places of Radhesham, or Radha Krishna, where Radha Krishna are installed. And it's extraordinary how Srila Prabhupada mentions this in the word-to-word translation, as these concentrates, in word-to-word translation. I'll just quickly try to find it. The chapter is called The Ideal Family Life. And I think it's verse 20. Yes. Oh, here, 30 to 33. Mm-hmm. Yes. It's together, those verses. I'm not going to read the Sanskrit. It's long, but I'll read the translation. The sacred lakes, like Pushkara and places where saintly persons live, like Kurukshetra, Gaya, Prayag, Pulahashram, Namisharanya, the banks of the Palgu River, Satubandha, Prabhasa, Dvarka, Varanasi, Mathura, Pampa, Bindusarovara, Badarika Ashram, the places where the Nanda River flows, the places where Lord Ramachandra and Mother Sita took shelter, such as Chitrakuta, and also the hilly tracts of land known as Mahendra and Malaya, all of these are to be considered most pious and sacred. Similarly, places outside India, where there are centers of the Krishna consciousness movement, that's in the translation of Bhagavatam verse, Prabhupada says like this, and where Radha Krishna deities are worshipped, must all be visited and worshipped by those who want to be spiritually advanced. One who intends to advance in spiritual life may visit all these places and perform ritualistic ceremonies to get results 1,000 times better than the results of the same activities performed in any other place. And if you look at the word-to-word translation, Prabhupada says, Archa Ashritaha, places where the deities of Radha Krishna is worshipped, such as big American cities like New York, Los Angeles, and San Francisco, and European cities like London and Paris, of whether there are centers of Krishna, wherever there are centers of Krishna consciousness. I really like that, Prabhupada. And Purport. In these verses, and in the verse 29, stress is given to one point, Harer Archa Shita Chaye, or Harer Archa. In other words, any place where the deity of the Supreme Personality of Godhead is worshipped by devotees is most significant. The Krishna Conscious Movement is giving the population of the entire world a chance to take advantage of Krishna consciousness through the ISKCON centers, where one may perform deity worship and chant the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, and in this way obtain results with effectiveness increased 1,000 times. This continues the best welfare activity for human society. Okay, I'll finish the purport. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted the Hare Krishna movement with installed deities to spread to every village and town in the world, so that everyone in the world might take advantage of this movement and become all auspicious in spiritual life. Without spiritual life, nothing is auspicious. Moga samoga karmano moga jnana vichetasa. No one can become successful in fruitive activities or speculative knowledge without being Krishna conscious. As recommended in the Shastras, everyone should be very eagerly interested in taking part in the Krishna conscious movement and understanding the value of spiritual life. So, yes, I really like this verse in the Srimad Bhagavatam, which is very inspiring, that we should be visiting such places where Radha Krishna deities are installed. In fact, Gaurangi deities also, because Gauranga Mahaprabhu is known different to Radha and Krishna. But why I'm quoting this all, or telling these stories, is because we have to have a practical engagement for the senses in order to receive this param dvishtvani vartate. How else we can have the higher taste if we don't experience that? And the beautiful part of it is that the more you reciprocate with Krishna by serving him, the more he responds to your surrender or to your service, to your efforts, to your sincerity. And unless you have this beautiful reciprocation experience, there's no way to overcome the senses and mind. I remember, you know, since I said this example about going to the deities 3 hours every Sunday, it sometimes was austere, you know, because the road, you know, the winter, and it just sometimes took, and the connections with the buses were sometimes not, like, it was very short, so you had to run, to the, you know, second bus, otherwise the last bus to the temple, because the temple was a little outside of Prague. It took 30 minutes to drive just by bus, but also the interval between buses was 1.5 hours. In other words, if you miss it, you miss the whole Sunday feast program. So it was really Yeah, and we were the whole group, and you could see it's, you know, the crazy Hare Krishna people running like anything for bars to take deity darshan and attend the program. But not only that, sometimes there were, of course, celebrations, and that was Sunday. And in Europe, Sundays are not like Sundays in America, that most shops are closed and you cannot get things easily. only the big supermarkets are open. And on that last stop, where you take the bus to the temple, there was a supermarket, but you had to run through the whole shopping mall to get to this supermarket. And so I had 9 minutes between that one bus and the other bus. And because one time it was like celebration, I remember I was running for my life to get some fruits for the deities. And I was really sprinting. So I got this pineapple, you know. And of course, while I was sprinting, I was praying, oh, please, Krishna, send me, you know, because I don't have time to choose. So please just guide my eyes so I get the good fruit, the ripe fruit, easily, what will please the Lord, and right, you know, get to the cashier, buy it, and run back to the bus. So I got this beautiful big pineapple, ripe, ready to eat. And it was celebration of some sort. I forgot if it was Nityananda Trayodashi or something. And I got this pineapple, and the next day, it was, I think at this time it was Saturday, and the next day, Sunday, we had Namahata program at our friend's place. So we went to this Namahata program the next day, and so, sorry, this pineapple went on the altar, was there for the whole, it was part of the decoration of the altar, and was there for the whole celebration. Advaitacharya, I think it was. And then the next day, we had this Namahata program, and I came, and that Namahata program was held at our senior Vaishnavi. She was a pujari at that temple. And she said, look what I have. I have this maha from yesterday's altar celebration for all of you to share with. She brings that same pineapple that I purchased for Lord's pleasure. And I had to laugh because, you know, it's always, how to say, it's always beautiful to, you cannot mix it up, this feeling in the heart, how, when you feel how Lord reciprocates with your efforts, you know. And so, and this gives this higher taste, this practical experience, and those some scars also, because you remember those things. And they rejuvenate your spiritual life. Because when the hard time comes and mind is restless, what do you have to do? How to pacify the mind? We have to get this strength, of course, from Sadhu Sangha, this is the best. But also, if you don't have access to Sadhu Sangha for whatever reason, you can access your Sadhu Sangha in your memory. the one you had just recently. How Lord has reciprocated with you. Given all you wanted in spiritual life. And also you can remember how He saved you from the dreadful situation and conditions of your conditioned life, which we quite often tend to forget. And this is exactly what this verse is about today. It says, once you're regenerated with Krishna consciousness, you're able to think and choose. Now you can choose. Do I actually continue being with devotees, associating, serving actively? Or shall I take the other track, just sense enjoyments? You can choose. Whereas conditioned soul, it cannot choose. I mean, when the conditioned soul doesn't know Krishna, it cannot choose. It just does what modes of nature dictates. It binded them, or they binded him, the conditioned soul, and now it can only dance how the modes of nature dictate them to dance. That's it. But the devotee of the Lord, he actually has the real freedom. That's why it says the regulative principles of freedom. In that also second chapter of Bhagavad Gita, there's a verse explaining that. And now we have this choice. But we should choose wisely. And before we choose wisely, we have to have that knowledge or memory to see the value of what we have received by His Divine Grace, Srila Prabhupada. I hope he's seen on the camera. Try to adjust it. We should always remember who we owe everything to. This is our eternal debt. And the only way to pay this debt is just continue to value that gift that we received and continue to share it with others. So I'll probably stop here. If there's comments by senior Vaishnavas and questions, then. Okay, maybe I'll say one more short story with Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada, he was a genius in every aspect. And he was also training disciples not to blindly follow. You know, he tried to develop their intelligence on many occasions. And I remember two stories. Unfortunately, I cannot quote them precisely where they happened because it was a long time I heard them. Long time ago I heard them. But maybe Taraka Prabhu will help me. So one story was, as far as I remember, was somewhere in North America or Canada. The Prabhupada was walking with his disciples on a morning walk, and he spotted some land and house, and he said, "Oh, this will be a good, you know, good Krishna. If we'll purchase this land, this will be a good spot for Krishna conscious center for temple." And everybody was, "Jai Srila Prabhupada!" And there's, "We'll build this big temple here." I'm just paraphrasing now because I don't even remember precisely it, but I just remember the essence of this story. "And we will build a beautiful temple here, and it will be like attracting in this neighborhood so many conditioned souls. Jai Srila Prabhupada." And then he said, "And we'll get this dog here also to guard. Jai Srila Prabhupada." And Prabhupada said, "Why do we need dog?" He just cut them off, like, "Why do we need the dog? You know, we just can have the temple. You know, dogs are unclean," and so forth and so forth. So all of a sudden, they woke up that Prabhupada is sometimes testing the disciples to actually think, not to just jai 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 Srila Prabhupada, but actually think what is needed for Krishna service and what is not necessary. It's just one example, but maybe I hope I can quote precisely this story with every detail I just remember on them like this. And another story was actually with GBC in Europe, in Germany. So there was some problem in Germany that Srila Prabhupada DBC tried to resolve, and Srila Prabhupada suggested them, "Okay, you just do like this. He gave them, again, I don't remember the details, it was some legal matter or something. So Prabhupada gave them instructions how to resolve this problem. They said, and he asked for their opinion and said, "Yes, Prabhupada, this sounds very, you know, very reasonable. We should do like this, like as you said." The next day he meets and Prabhupada said, "Actually, I was thinking about it last night. No, we should do it like this, because this, what I just told you, will lead to these consequences. So rather we do like this." And he like reverted it. He made a complete reversal of that strategy. And he said, "What do you think?" And I said, "Yes, Prabhupada, this is very reasonable. This is, yeah, we will just go with this." And the next day, Prabhupada gathered them again and said, "You know what? I thought about it. Actually, the first strategy was better, because the second will lead to these consequences, and this, if we just do it like this, actually, this will be much better. What do you think?" They said, "Oh, yes, Prabhupada, yes, this is very good." "Yeah, we'll just follow." He said, "But what about you? Why are you not bringing the strategy? Why are you sitting here, GBC man? You have to think. You have to give me those strategies. Why do you rely on me to do this? I'm not going to be here forever." And so he chastised them very profusely. And so we have this feeling, willing, you know, and thinking abilities. We should use them in Krishna consciousness, and this is the engagement for Krishna consciousness. The favorite story which our Dhruva Maharaj, he likes to quote, that was in Montreal temple when they were just buying it, I think. It was too much anxiety because it was too expensive, but then Prabhupada said in the end to purchase it, and he said, "We must have anxiety for Krishna." So the point about that is that anxiety also means thinking, right? So if we're not in anxiety for Krishna, for service of Krishna, then we will be in anxiety and fear and other things which are mentioned in this particular chapter. The king, Puranjana, he was in anxiety, you know, where's my wife, how are they feeling, and like this. So in anxiety for sense enjoyment. But anxiety for Krishna is different. It actually brings bliss, believe it or not. Only it looks externally the same. All right, I said enough of stories. still would like to leave the space for comments and questions now. Thank you for your class. I especially like the points you made about Paramdrishta and Vartata, and also the points about Sadhusanga. And if you don't have it, you can remember those memories you have with devotees. Remind me how these. There is always the opportunity to serve Krishna and his devotees and remember the Lord and his devotees. Yes, and also to look forward. In fact, maybe this is an important point. Bhaktivedanta Goswami Maharaj said in this regard about Ajamil, that all of those samskaras he had, he could not overcome. And the result that he could not overcome those samskaras was his life, you know, being engaged with this prostitute and had so many children and had to do so many bad activities. But when he saw the Vishnu Dutas, and also he saw the Yama Dutas, he knew, he got the knowledge, he got the bright future ahead of him. He said, okay, if I just do devotional service, I'll attain this, I'll attain them, and I will not attain that. He actually saw it. So Om Agyana Timirandasya, so when spiritual master enlightens us and gives our vision what to look forward to back home, back to Godhead, then this vision helps us also to, not that we forget the samskaras completely, we cannot forget them, that's why it's called samskaras or vasanas, deep impressions, but we can, not pay them so much attention because we are looking forward to something else. And in other words, our meditation is in the bright future rather than in the dark past. So in this way, those samskaras becomes weaker while the devotional service future becomes very bright. So that's why Ajamil was able to, once he had this experience and saw the bright future, what he did, you know, the continuation of the story is that although he was old, he left the house and started to perform devotional service, worship the Lord, and attain perfection. Because he still had to live a little bit after that scary and also blissful experience that he went through. So yes, Deviki Priti, this is a great thing. We can remember the old, but also we should look forward to the future and, like Akrura, meditate on when we will meet Krishna. And we can also practice it here in the material world, because we have those Vaikuntha centers or Galoka centers. That story my spiritual master likes to quote in Melbourne, when Prabhupada was in a temple, he was saying, you know how Prabhupada sometimes gets into it and starts to roar. He said, this is actually not Melbourne. This is spiritual world, this is Vaikuntha, and everybody, Jai Prabhupada! No, this is not Vaikuntha, this is Vrindavan! And everybody was like, Jai Prabhupada! You know, those emotions were just so high. But Prabhupada was in that spiritual consciousness, he could just contaminate, it was so contagious, everybody was catching it. And yeah, when my spiritual master tells this story, he tells this with such a juice, you know, he really liked that. Lecture of Prabhupada. And of course, he's GBC in Australia, so he quotes it in Melbourne, and devotees become all ecstatic. All right. Charaka Prabhu, would like to conclude or say a few words?
I don't really have anything to contribute. I'm sorry. I'm particularly exhausted today. Thank you for your class. It's very nice to hear.
Thank you, Tariq Prabhu, that despite of physical condition you hear in Srimad Bhagavatam, although from such unqualified persons, but thank you very much for your example for all of us. Okay, there's one more comment. Thank you for explaining this important point about looking forward to the future. Yes, thank you. All right, I think we're opening our altar in 2 minutes. So, Grantaraj, Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Yitai go premanande hari hari bo.